to Butterfly Beauty. So most would say you're a little too obsessed with makeup when you start matching your makeup looks to your jewelry. Well, I'm all about that life. Today I created a gunmetal smoky eye, bronze luminous skin, and a nude matte lip to complement this beautiful statement piece from Marina. I have a coupon code for you if you're interested in checking out any of their beautiful and unique jewelry. So let's get into this look. My skin definitely needed some smoothing action today, so I started priming with the Dr. Brandt Pores No More. Then to color correct my breakouts and redness, I used the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Redness. I placed it on those problem areas with my fingertips and then started the blending process by stippling it into the skin with the Sigma P80 Flat Precision Brush. I'm using the Dior Skin Star Foundation and I'm applying it to the skin with a damp beauty blender. This is medium coverage, so I use about 4 pumps to cover my entire face and get my desired coverage. I'm in the shade 010 Ivory. Shocker, it's the lightest shade. And I absolutely love the luminous, radiant finish this gives to my skin. I'm going to be cream contouring and highlighting with this BB Matte Contour Kit by Dr. Yart. Starting off with the bronze shade, I'm going to be contouring underneath my cheekbones and also along my hairline and temples. This product is extremely pigmented, so you don't need a whole lot, and I find that it's very easy to blend out with a duo fiber brush. To conceal the dark circles under my eyes, I'm going to be using the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector. To highlight the high points in my face, the areas where I want to draw attention to, I'm using the Neutralize and Highlight shades from the Dr. Yart Kit. Then just taking the Neutralize shade, I'm going to be placing it underneath my contour in order to really make it pop. Then again, using both shades, I'm going to be concealing and highlighting my under eye area. Make sure to thumbs up this video if you would like me to do an in-depth tutorial on how I contour and highlight. To avoid creasing, I conceal one under eye area at a time and immediately go into set that with my go-to MAC Pro Emphasize Shaping Powder and Real Techniques Contour Brush. Next, with a Redampen Beauty Blender and my Laura Mercier Translucent Setting Powder, I'm placing the powder onto the areas of my face that tend to crease, so I'm going on my chin, around my mouth, my nose, and my forehead. Then I'm taking a tulip brush to give a sheer application of powder to the cheek area to avoid it from getting cakey, but to set it so our other powders go on nice and smooth. Moving on to eyes, I primed my lids with the MAC Painterly Paint Pot, setting that with the translucent powder. I'm going to be using the Morphe 35K palette to create my gunmetal smoky eye, starting off with the frosty white shade to highlight the brow bone area. For my transition color, I'm taking this warm light brown shade and I'm applying it to the area right above my crease using a fluffy Videlum Tools 785 brush. Next, I'll be taking this cool chocolate brown on a Smith 247 brush to start carving out my crease using windshield wiper motions. And I also pack this color on the outer third of my eye. Adding this cool chocolate shade to the outer third of the eye will make it easier to blend out darker shades as we work to increase the pigmentation in the outer V. So now I'm taking this dark slate shade with shimmery reflexive silver, and then again I'm going to be blending that out with the Smith 247 brush. I'm going to be applying this beautiful silver shade to the inner third of the eye on a Smith 253 brush. Then I'm taking this gorgeous gunmetal shade and I'm going to be applying it from the outer third to meet the silver. The key to any good smoky eye is to continually blend out and then add pigmentation. So I'm darkening up the outer V and again blending that out. To continue the blending process, I'm just taking a clean, fluffy, tapered brush and blending out the outer edge of the eye. Now we're going to be giving the lid an amplified metallic effect. I'm taking this cool champagne shade, wetting my brush with Fix Plus, putting it on the inner third of the eye. Then applying the gunmetal shade to meet the inner third of the eye where we applied it earlier. I'm applying this shimmery taupe shade to the area where the dark and light shades meet on the lid to ensure a seamless transition. Next, I'm darkening up the crease even further and then blending out the transition once more. Now moving on to the lower lash line, I'm taking this Maybelline Define Align in Soft Black, applying it to my waterline and right below my lower lashes. I'm going to be stamping out the lower lash line with the gunmetal shade on a flat definer brush. Then to really amplify the smoky effect and blend out the gunmetal shade and liner, I'm taking the cool chocolate shade on a Sigma E30 pencil brush, blending from outer corner to inner corner. I applied the Ardell Demi Wispies off camera and I'm just concealing that lash band with some black gel liner and applying the MAC Giga Black Lash on my lower lashes. Moving back to the complexion, I'm adding warmth and structure with the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. Next, I'll be doing a little reverse contouring with the MAC Studio Fix powder, applying it right underneath my contour to really make it pop. Then on a medium angled shading brush, I'm taking some more of that bronzer down the bridge of my nose, and I'm going to be blending that out with some more of the Studio Fix powder on a Real Techniques setting brush. Next, I'm stippling some more of that powder onto my lower jawline area to amp up the coverage. For a bomb highlight, I'm taking the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit and Gleam, first taking Crushed Pearl, which is described as a glimmering pink and silver with a crystallized chrome finish. This definitely gives that effect. I'll be sandwiching Mimosa between the Crushed Pearl highlight and the bronzer. This will give us a nice peachy glow, topping that off with MAC's Warm Soul. For the ultimate nude pout, I'm lining my lips with MAC's Strip Down, and then I'll be applying the NYX Lingerie Liquid Lipstick in Satin Ribbon. Last but not least, I will be setting the powders into the skin with MAC's Fix Plus. This is the completed makeup look. All products I use will be listed in the description bar down below. I will see you in my next one. Remember, you're beautiful inside and out.